हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू एवरेज क्लासेस। ओके, सो एज यू नो कि आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ एवरी चैप्टर वी सॉल्व इट्स न्यूमेरिकल। ओके, वी सॉल्व न्यूमेरिकल सेपरेटली टू, बट आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ एवरी चैप्टर वी सॉल्व न्यूमेरिकल। तो वी आर गोना सॉल्व मॉड्यूल 1 चैप्टर 2, दैट इज योर फ्लूइड स्टैटिक्स। ओके, न्यूमेरिकल। नाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन विच आई एम रेफरिंग, यू विल फाइंड द गूगल ड्राइव लिंक टू दिस इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन। तो प्लीज डाउनलोड दिस क्वेश्चन पेपर फ्रॉम द लिंक इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन, सो दैट वी कैन प्रोसीड इट। ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स गो फॉर इट। डाउनलोड हो गया, डन, गुड। सो सी द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। द क्वेश्चन हियर, व्हाट आर द न्यूमेरिकल्स वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग, द रेंज ऑफ द क्वेश्चन इज मीडियम और इजी। ओके, इट्स नॉट दैट हार्ड, दे आर इजी। सी द प्रेशर इन मीटर्स ऑफ ऑयल ऑफ स्पेसिफिक ग्रेविटी 0.8। सो ऑयल स्पेसिफिक ग्रेविटी इज गिवन 0.8, s ऑफ ऑयल इज गिवन 0.8, equivalent to 80 meter of water. The head of water is given how much? 80 meter. So the question is, what will be the pressure of oil, okay, in terms of head of water, equal to the pressure created by a water level of 80 meter. That is the question. Simple. You go here, rho oil g h oil is equal to rho water G H water. They are asking what is the H oil. So this implies your H oil equal to rho water upon rho oil multiply H water. Rho density of water is how much, sir? 1000. So what is your density of oil? So if specific gravity is 0.8, what will be density? 800. Super. Multiply H of water. So this is what it will become, 10/8. मल्टीप्लाइंग हेच ऑफ वॉटर, हाउ मच? 80. तो हाँ, यू विल गेट 100 मीटर। द आंसर इज 100 मीटर। ठीक है, दिस इज योर क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. अंडरस्टूड? दे आर आस्किंग द आंसर, दे आर नॉट आस्किंग द प्रेशर ऑफ ऑयल, दे आर आस्किंग द प्रेशर ऑफ ऑयल इन टर्म्स ऑफ हेड ऑफ ऑयल। सो दिस मच हेड ऑफ ऑयल विल क्रिएट अ प्रेशर इक्विवेलेंट टू द प्रेशर क्रिएटेड बाय 80 मीटर ऑफ वॉटर। ठीक है, सुपर, fantastic. Now question number 2. A specific gravity of a liquid given, how much? 0.75 is the specific gravity of the liquid. So density will be, sir, 750 kg per meter cube. What height of that liquid is needed to provide a pressure difference of 200 kilopascal? Delta P is given 200 kilopascal. See, kilopascal is there, convert into pascal. So 200 multiply 1000 pascal. So they are asking delta P equal to rho g h. How much head will be equivalent to delta P, that is 2 lakh pascal, given the density of the liquid is 750 kg per meter cube. Sir, these are very simple questions. Yes, that's what I am telling. Very, very easy questions. Okay, density how much? 750 multiply gravity, for simplicity take 10. You can take 9.81 also, then h. Now from this you tell me the value of h. I have solved it, and the h I am getting around is 27.18 meter. Okay, solve and tell me whether you got the same answer or you are getting any different answer. Okay, done. हो गया, पॉज द वीडियो, नोट इट डाउन, पॉज द वीडियो एंड नोट इट डाउन। ओके, सो आई एम इरेजिंग नाउ, यू अंडरस्टूड? टू क्वेश्चंस, वेरी वेरी इजी। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, रीड द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, व्हेन आई एम इरेजिंग द बोर्ड, रीड व्हाट इट इज सेइंग क्वेश्चन नंबर 3। सर, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 इज टेलिंग कि यू हैव अ यूट्यूब मैनोमीटर ओपन एट बोथ एंड। अच्छा, so we have some U2 manometer like this, which is open at both the ends. Okay, so सबसे पहला काम, सुंदर डायग्राम। ओके, ड्रॉ द डायग्राम प्रॉपरली। ठीक है, सो ओपन एट बोथ द एंड्स एंड मेड अप ऑफ 8 mm डाया। व्हाट इज द डायमीटर ऑफ द ट्यूब? सर, डाया ऑफ द ट्यूब इज 8 mm। सुपर, made up of 8 mm dia glass tube. Mercury is at the bottom of height of 10 cm above the horizontal layer. See, up to this you have mercury. Aa ja re, mercury to aa ja. Mercury. So from horizontal limb, this height is given how much? How much they are given, sir? It is given 10 centimeter. Mercury is there. Okay, this is your Mercury. Now what you have done? You being the smart guy, what you have done? You have added 19 cc of water to one limb. Okay, one limb. So now what you have poured? What water you have poured? How much water you have poured? Sir, 19 cc of water I have poured. Very, very good. Water. You have poured water. Now, what will happen? What will happen? Because you have poured water, there will be some pressure fluctuation and the mercury on the other limb will now rise. Mercury in the other limb is going to rise. Let us say, some amount it will rise. We do not know how much amount will rise. Let us say mercury has rose up to this. And your water level has come up to this. Okay? Because you have added 19 cc of water. Because of that pressure, your water has come up to this. So now this is your new mercury balance. So I am removing. This is height of mercury. H mercury. Okay? Understood? You understood this much? What happened? What happened? Because you added 19 cc of water, some pressure increased here. Now to balance the pressure, okay, it has some amount of mercury has right risen in the right limb. So the question they are asking is, what is the difference in mercury level at equilibrium? So in this condition they have reached mercury, they have reached the equilibrium. So this much is the height of mercury level. They are asking what will be the height of mercury level. Okay. This is your height of water. This is your height of water. This we do not know. We need to find that. How we are going to find it? Volume is given. How much volume of water is given? Sir, it is given 19 cc. Cc matlab cubic centimeter. Cc means cubic centimeter. That means area multiply head of water is 19 cc. So this implies head of water will be, sir, 19 cc divided by area. What is the area? Area of the tube. This cross sectional area of the tube multiplied the height is nothing but the 19 cc what you have applied. Yes or no? Sir, correct, sir. You are right. Area, sir, pi by 4. D square, sir, 8. No, Baba, not 8, 0.8. This is in cc. You have to write this in terms of cubic centimeters. So everything should be in centimeter. Now solve the value H water. You will get some value of H water. Okay. H water. So, okay. If you want to solve, I can solve the value and tell me what is the value of H water. Okay. Now, once you got H water, see, this is your point A and this is your point B. What Pascal's law say? Sir, at this point, the pressure at point A and the pressure at point B will be same. Because they are at same horizontal level and same continuous mass of liquid is flowing. So, A point at pressure at A, pressure at B will be same. So, as per Pascal's law, pressure at A will be equal to pressure at B. So, what is your pressure at A? Sir, pressure at A equal to this height. Pressure at A equal to this height. The pressure because of water of this height. That is rho water g h water. Pressure at B means what? Pressure at B is because of this much height of mercury. Okay. So, rho mercury g h mercury. What in question they have asked? Sir, in question they have asked height of mercury. So, this implies height of mercury is equal to anyhow g g cut t rho w rho of water divided by rho of mercury multiply h of water. Rho of water you know 1000, rho of mercury you know 13600, multiply h of water. You get the answer from here. Multiply h of water, put this. How much you'll get? I know only the mercury answer. How much the answer you'll get is 2.8 centimeter. This will be a answer. Height of mercury. Solve this and tell me whether you got the same answer or not. Okay? Understood? Very good. Very, very good. Note it down fast. Pause the video, note it down. Okay? Now, since I am erasing this, you try हाँ यू ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट द क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर. क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर इज इजी, देयर इज नॉट मच यू नो डिफिकल्टी इन क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर. इट इज एक्चुअली अ वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन. हाँ व्हाट दे हैव गिवन सर, दे हैव गिवन द रेशियोस ऑफ एरिया. हाउ मच इज द रेशियोस ऑफ एरिया सर, रेशियोस ऑफ एरिया इज 500. अरे वाह. सो व्हाट दे आर आस्किंग, व्हाट दे आर आस्किंग, सो दे आर आस्किंग व्हाट इज द एरर. देखो सो यू हैव ड्रॉन सम डायग्राम लाइक दिस बट देयर इज अ मिस्टेक. See, del h is the mistake you have done. If you refer the question and the diagram, last time also we are doing, while solving this in the theory also I have told the del h value is very less, so we are neglecting. But here they are asking find the error. Find the error. Okay. The cross section area of a loop, so capital A is 500 times the small a. So small a by capital A is how much? 1 by 500. Very very good. So that the difference between the limbs are determined by mercury h. ठीक है. So what they are asking is take the volume on the left limb. Volume on the left is nothing but your volume equal to in the right. How much volume will add the water in the left hand side? Same only will rise in the right hand side because the liquid is same. So this implies what is your volume, sir? A into delta h. That side, sir, A into capital H. The rise is capital H. What they are asking? Percentage error. That is delta H by H they are asking in percentage. This implies small a by capital H. If you have to convert into percent, you have to multiply by 100. So small a by capital A, how much? 1 by 500. Multiply 100, sir, 1 by 5. 1 by 5 is how much? 0.2%. So the error is very less. So we can always neglect this much. 0.2 is okay error, well, not that much significant. Now question number 5. Interesting, very easy but interesting. But by seeing the diagram only, sometimes we feel fear. Nothing to fear. Oh my dear, fluid mechanics is here. So this is going to be a very easy one. We have already solved some numericals like this. Okay, so you have mercury till this. This is your mercury level. Okay, so up to this much your mercury height. How much is given? 10 centimeter. This is your mercury. Now you have some pressure here, P, some liquid, and that liquid is up to this much height is. How much is given the height? Sir, the height is given 60 centimeters, sir. Superb. Okay, superb. And what the fluid which is there inside, what is the S of the fluid? Sir, especially gravity of the fluid is 0.85. What they are asking? What is the pressure at P in terms of oil column? This in terms of height of H. Okay, gauge pressure they are asking. See, you need not to confuse this kind of numerical. Always, always remember your Pascal. What he say? So the pressure at here and the pressure here will be same. So these two pressure and cancelling out. Okay. Now here same oil level is there. So the pressure at here and the pressure at here will be same. Means A, B, C. The PA and PB will be same. So but we can neglect this. And if you go like this, the PB and PC, this much portion also we can neglect. So only thing which is, you know, we need is the pressure of OA and the pressure of CD. Only thing we need is pressure because of OA and pressure because of CD. Very good. Therefore, pressure at P is equal to the pressure because of oil column, the pressure and pressure because of the mercury column. Okay. So this implies, sir, up you are going, so you will write negative. Na? Yes, negative I write from in this side. Okay, so that's why I took it from the right hand side, became positive. So P oil, rho oil G H oil plus rho mercury G H mercury. So what is your rho oil? Sir, rho oil is 850 acceleration due to gravity. H oil is 60 centimeter convert into meter 0.6 plus mercury 13,600 multiplied by 9.81. into height of mercury, how much? 0.1. So you will get some value. Okay. You tell me the value. Pause the video. Tell me the value. How much you are getting? I need the value to proceed. Or else what we can do is they are asking the answer in terms of head of oil. Okay, they are not asking the answer in terms of Pascal. They are asking the answer in terms of head of oil. So this I will write P equal to rho oil multiply G multiply total head of oil. Okay, total head of oil is equal to this value. Okay, I am taking 9.81 common, that is 850 into 0.6 plus 13,600 into 0.1 multiply 0.1. Okay, so rho oil you know how much? 850. Now this G and this G you can cancel for simplicity of your answer. So H oil total H oil, you go ahead with this 850 into 0.6 plus this is 1360 divided by your oil. How much? 850. So the answer you will get is 2.2 meters. The answer you will get is 2.2 meters. Means the total pressure at this point is 2.2 meter head. 2.2 meter head of oil. Head of oil. Okay. Chalo, note it down first. Go to your question number 6. Read your question number 6. Sir, they are asking the total pressure, that is a hydrostatic force, on a circular plate. The diameter of the circular plate is given 2 meter. Dia is given how much? 2 meter. And at what depth it is? 1 meter depth. How the circular plate is kept? Sir, horizontally it has kept. Like this it has kept. Okay, horizontally it has kept. So, your H bar will be nothing but at what depth they have given? Same that depth only. Okay, you have something like this. Okay, so this is at a depth of 1 meter. The diameter of the circular plate is 2 meter. They are asking what? So they are asking the hydrostatic force F. F is equal to rho G H bar A. Superb. Rho into G 9810 H bar 1 meter given in question. Area pi by 4 D square. D is 2 square. If you solve it, you will get 30.8 kilonewton. Okay? Question number 6. Question number 7 also, they are asking the hydrostatic force of a circular surface area. Area is here given 1 meter square. Very easy. Centroid H bar is already given 1 meter below the free surface of the liquid. See, the purpose of solving this kind of easy question is to make you habituated with the formula F equal to rho G H bar A. Okay. So, F is equal to rho G H bar A. Rho how much? Sir, this is 9810 multiply 1 multiply 1. 9.81 kilonewton. This is your question number 6 and 7. See, 8, 9, 10 we'll do afterwards. Now let us go for question number 11. Question number 11. What they are saying? You have a sphere or hemisphere, is it? Yes. You have a hemisphere like this. Okay? Hemispheric object diameter D was immersed in water with its plane surface coinciding with the water. The plane surface of the hemisphere is coinciding with the water. How much is the diameter? So the diameter is given D. Okay. Its plane surface coinciding with the water. What is the vertical component of hydrostatic force? This is which kind of surface here? So this is curved surface. This is which surface? Curved surface. So what is the vertical component of curved surface formula? Sir, it is the weight of the liquid supported. It is the weight of the liquid supported or weight. Yes or no? Yes, correct. Supported. Okay, so what is weight? Weight equal to mass into gravity, m into g. Mass is what, sir? Mass is equal to, can I just write it somewhere here so that I can save space for one more numerical, m into g. Okay, so mass means, sir, density into volume multiply g. Rho into g I am writing gamma. See, the options, everything is given in terms of gamma. What is gamma? Gamma is the weight density. Weight density equal to rho into g. We have studied this in properties of fluid. Okay. First chapter, I think. Introduction. Such. Okay. Fluid mechanics by average classes. FM by average classes. Okay. Or curved surface by average classes. You will get it. Rho into volume into g. That is gamma into multiply volume. What is volume? Sir, this is the volume of a hemisphere. Sphere formula is 4 by 3 pi r cube. So, what will be hemisphere? Half of that. So, 1 by 2 multiply 4 by 3 pi r cube. Arre bah, you are getting the answer. Gamma 1 by 2 multiply 4 by 3 pi r is diameter. So, d cube upon 8. R is B by 2. So DQ upon 8. So now you can see, 4 ones are 4 twos are. So how much I'm getting? Gamma by 12 pi B. That was the, in the option. In option it was there. Okay. Gamma by 12 pi DQ. Ho gaya question number 11. Now see, question number 12 is interesting. Try to understand. You have a tank. Okay. You have a tank like this. Tank. So you have one tank like this. Okay. Arre sir, kya kar rahe ho sir?
क्या कर रहे हो सर?
Why you are doing this? Why sir? Why इतना easy diagram also you are running, ruining the diagram for us. ठीक है बाबा, ठीक है, क्या है? ठीक है. Whatever you say. ठीक है. So this is your tank. This it said four equal vertical faces of width W. So the width of this faces are what? W. This face W. Again, this face width is W. Width is W. Height is H.
Okay, height is H. Width is W.
Filled with liquid. Till the top, you have filled with the liquid. Okay. If the force on any vertical face is equal to the force at the bottom. Super. See, what is the height force at vertical face is equal to force at the bottom. What will be the force at any vertical plane? Sir, rho g h bar a. Fantastic. So, what will be the force at the bottom? Sir, this will be rho g h a. H into a. Because pressure at the bottom is rho g h. The pressure because of height h and area a. So, this implies, okay, I'm considering rho g cut it. H bar. How much will be the h bar here? That is cg. Half of the vertical plane. That is h by 2. Multiply area. What is the area of this vertical plate, sir? H into W. H multiply W. What will be the area of the bottom, sir? Area of the bottom is W into W. That is W. So H cancel. So what is the ratio of H by W you are getting? So the ratio of H by W you are getting is 2. Okay. Read the question again and try to understand what I just told. ठीक है, नोट इट डाउन और विल गो फॉर वन मोर प्रॉब्लम. वी कैन गो फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 13. डायमेंशन ऑफ प्रेशर ग्रेडियंट देयर आस्किंग. सी डायमेंशन प्रेशर ग्रेडियंट, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय ग्रेडियंट? ग्रेडियंट मींस एवरीथिंग डिवाइडेड बाय लेंथ. सी मास मींस नॉर्मली स्पेसिफिक विल कम, टाइम रेट विल कम. ओके, व्हाट इज रेट ऑफ वेलोसिटी? मींस वेलोसिटी बाय टाइम, दैट इज योर एक्सीलरेशन यू विल गेट. व्हाट इज ग्रेडियंट ऑफ प्रेशर? व्हाट इज ग्रेडियंट ऑफ वेलोसिटी? Anything gradient means divided by length. So they are asking pressure gradient. That is what? Pressure P by length. Pressure means what? Sir, it is Pascal. Length unit is meter. Pascal means, sir, Pascal means Newton per meter square by meter. Achha, what is Newton? Sir, Newton is kg meter per second square. This now meter square I am taking it down. So I'll get 1 by meter cube. So this cancel. So what you got? Kg meter to the power minus 2, second to the power minus 2, or m l minus 2 t minus 2. This is your dimension of pressure gradient. Okay? Note it down first. Try to read the question number 8 and visualize. Okay. You have a horizontal tank. The height of the horizontal tunnel. Height of the horizontal tunnel is 5 and the width is 3. Let us say this tunnel is at some container, some tank or some dam somewhere. You have a horizontal tunnel. Okay. Now, which is full of water. Okay. There is some water here. Now, to close the horizontal tunnel, I am using a gate. I don't know the width, length, anything about the gate. I don't know. So, I have some gate. Okay. Now, the pressure at the bottom of the gate. The pressure at bottom of the gate is given 2 into 10 to the power 4 kg per meter square. Okay. So, somewhat I am expecting the pressure distribution is like this. Okay. As the height increases, yes, what happens to your pressure? Pressure, depth increases, pressure also increases. So, let us say the pressure distribution is something like this. Okay.
honestly I don't know what is the height now.
So I need to calculate the pressure. So this implies I know pressure equal to rho of g h. Remember the answer, the what they have given is in terms of kg per meter square. It is not in newton per meter square, but our unit of pressure is pascal. Pascal is newton per meter square. Newton per meter square. So you have to multiply gravity here, acceleration due to gravity, or remove the gravity from here. So 2 into 10 to the power 4 multiply, and here 10 the gravity I multiply, density is 1000, g is 10, height. So from here I got height of the gate up to which the pressure is acting is 20 meter. That means if this portion is 5 meter, what will be this height? Sir, this height is going to be a 15 meter. 15 meter plus 5 meter is 20 meter up to where your vertical gate is closing. So what they are asking is, what will be the hydraulic pressure? What will be the hydrostatic force on the gate? Okay, we know the formula. Our formula is F equal to rho g h bar a. Rho is 1000, g is 10. Now coming to h bar. Where the h bar will write? Sir, cg of this. So what will be cg of this? Sir, half of this point, that is 2.5 meter. Plus from the free surface, how much distance? 15 meter. So the cg is going to be 15 plus 2.5 meter. Multiply area. What is the area of this tunnel you are getting? Sir, area is given 5 into 3. So you solve for this answer. Whatever value you are getting, that is your, that much only your, what do you call, force acting on the gate. Note down first. Option answer is around 2625 kilonewton. Okay, that's, you can find at the bottom also. Okay, this is your question number 8. Now we'll go to question number 9. That also we need a diagram. Okay. Note down and try for question number 9. Question number 9. Again, an interesting question. So you have a sliding gate. The sliding gate is 3 meter wide and 1.5 meter depth. Okay. Lies in a vertical plane and has a coefficient of friction. Mu is given 0.2. Okay. Between itself and the guide. The gate weights, the self weight of the gate acting vertically downward. Weight is 19.6 what? Kilonewton. And its upper edge is at a depth of 10 meter. Upper edge. So this upper edge, whatever you are seeing, this is at a depth of how much meter? 10 meter. Superb. Okay. Determine the vertical force required to raise the lift. So you want to raise the lift like this. This is your vertical force F. Okay. Vertical force is trying to lift the gate. So if you are lifting the gate towards up, which side your frictional force will act? Downward. That is your frictional force. So they are asking, what is the vertical force F? So your vertical force F is equal to, from this diagram, the weight, self weight plus the frictional force. Plus the frictional force. Okay. Weight is given 19.6. What is your frictional force? Sir, formula is mu into Rn. Okay. The reaction. The normal reaction. Rn is nothing but the normal reaction. Rn. Okay. So this implies 19.6 plus mu is 0.2. Rn. Now, how to calculate Rn? This Rn is nothing but your hydrostatic force. So this formula is your rho g h bar a. Rho g h bar a. So this implies 19.6 plus 0.2 multiply by 1000 multiply by 9.81 h bar 10 meter from the surface plus half of 1.5 meter. So 10 plus 1.5, half of 1.5 meter is how much, sir? 0.75. Multiply area. Area is already, 3 into 1.5. If you solve this, you will get an answer around, I think, 114.5 kilometer. Okay, solve this first.
Check whether answer is matching my answer or not. So now let's solve your next question number 10. See, read the question number 10. What it has said?
You have a rectangular plate. There is a rectangular plate of 0.75 meter into 2.4 meter. It is immersed in a liquid. So this particular rectangular plate is now immersed in a liquid. Okay, super. Very, very good. Okay. So, what is the specific gravity of the liquid? Sir, the specific gravity of the liquid is given 0.85. Now, its horizontal 0.75 meter side is horizontal. So, this side is horizontal. So, can you imagine? It is like this. So if I draw the plate, actually this is some part like this, but this portion is inside. Okay, so its 0.75 meter side is horizontal and touching the plane. ठीक है, and making an angle how much? 60 degree. They are asking, what is the pressure force and what is the center of pressure? So they are asking your, F, that is hydrostatic pressure force, and H star. Super. So now where the center of gravity will act? Lie, sir. It will lie here. And this distance, see, G, it is a G. And let us say this is the center of pressure P. So this distance is how much, sir? 1.2 meter. Half. 1.2 meter. From the surface, this is your H bar. And from the surface, this point is your H star. ठीक है, very good. This all we have already discussed. Where? In the theory, inclined plane surface. So take sine 60. If you take sine 60, what will be sine? Sir, it is opposite side by, opposite side by your hypotenuse. So that is your H bar upon 1.2 meter. So this implies my H bar, I got 1.2 sine 60. 1.2 sine 60. See. What you use? Virtual calci. Virtual calci, how you are going to use sine 60? First you have to type 60. First you have to type 60. Then you have to type sine. Don't type sine and 60. No, that's not how your virtual calci work. That's why I told you, if you are solving gate numericals and all, you must use virtual calci only. Don't use your like the Casio or some other calci you are using. So 1.2 sine 60. So first you type 60, then sine. Now multiply 1.2. Now multiply 1.2. So I am getting this value as 1.04 meter. ठीक है? Very good. Very, very good. So I need to calculate F. What is your force? Sir, this is rho G H bar A. Wow. So if your specific gravity is 0.85, then what will be your density? Sir, specific gravity into density of water, that is 0.85 multiply 1000, that is your 850. So, specific gravity is 850, multiply gravity G 9.81, H bar already I got 1.04, multiply A, area, how much is the area, sir? 0.75 into 2.4 multiply 0.75. Very, very good. Now tell me how much is the hydrostatic force you are getting? Come on, fast, multiply. Superb. Are you following me? Are you getting your answer or not? 4 multiply 0.75. Okay, so I am getting an answer 15,598.122 newton. Normally they will give these options in kilonewton. So 15.598 kilonewton. This much is your hydrostatic force. So option A answer you got. Next, what you have to get? Sir, the center of pressure, that is H star. What is the formula of H star? Sir, H star is equal to H of bar upon IG, that is sine square theta upon AH bar. Right, wow. So what we know? We already know H bar. We know sine theta. We know A. We do not know IG. So calculate IG. What will be your IG? Sir, this is BDQ by 2L. How much is your B? 0.75. Telling na 0.75 side is touching there. Multiply depth 1.2 whole cube divided by 12. Do it. 1.2. See, here is the XQ symbol. Just click it. You will get cube of 1.2. Virtual calci saves your time if you know it properly. Okay. Virtual calci saves your time if you know it properly. Okay. So how much answer you are getting? Sorry. Diameter is 2.4. What I am writing here? You guys are also not telling me. Sir, you have written wrong. Multiply by 0.75 divided by 12. So I am getting IG value is 0.864 meter to the power 4th. Okay. IG we got. Now, so H bar is how much? 1.04 plus IG how much? 0.864 multiply sine square theta, that is sine 60 whole square. Sine 60 whole square divided by area. Area is 2.4. Multiply 0.75. Okay, AH bar. H bar is how much? 1.04. If you put all this, how much your answer you will get? I have already given the answer response sheet here. That is, you will get 1.39 meter. This is your H star. A very simple problem numerical we have solved now. Okay, come on, pause the video, note it down. See, for your next question, question number 13 over question number 14. When a block of ice floating on a water in a container melts, the level of the water in the container same. See, the density of ice is less. Okay, it's already floating. Means how much? Means the buoyancy force and the weight of the buoyancy force and the weight of your ice cube, that is already balanced. So it won't take much volume even if it melts. It won't occupy already how much volume it has to occupy. It has occupied. If it melts, that means it become liquid. Liquid density is more than that. Water density is more than the density of ice itself. So it will occupy same level. So there will won't be any change in the any change in the water level. Okay, that is your question number 14. Now question number 15 is interesting. Okay, it is very interesting and so many times in so many exams it has come. Okay, it's 15th is the you want to call master question. So I have given a solution of the question number 15. You try to go through the solution. Okay, I'm not covering that in this video. I'll be covering a separate video for question number 15 itself. Okay, so very good. Keep practicing, and if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please do subscribe. Thank you.